Kells was tightening the cinch on her saddle while he spoke. His voice, his manner, the amiable smile on his intelligent face, they all appeared to come from sincerity. But for those strange eyes Joan would have wholly believed him. As it was, a half-doubt troubled her. She remembered the character Roberts had given this man. Still, she was recovering her nerve. It had been the certainty of disaster to Roberts that had made her weaken. As he was only slightly wounded and free to ride home safely, she had not the horror of his death upon her. Indeed, she was now so immensely uplifted that she faced the situation unflinchingly. "Bill," called Kells to the man standing there with a grin on his coarse red face, "you go back and help Halloway pack. Then take my trail." Bill nodded and was walking away when Kells called after him. "And say, Bill, don't say anything to Roberts. He's easily riled." "Ha ha," laughed Bill. His harsh laughter somehow rang jarringly in Joan's ears, but she was used to violent men who expressed mirth over mirthless jokes. "Get up, Miss Randall," said Kells as he mounted. "We've a long ride. You'll need all your strength, so I advise you to come quietly with me and not try to get away. It won't be any use trying." Joan climbed into her saddle and rode after him. Once she looked back in hope of seeing Roberts, of waving a hand to him. She saw his horse standing saddled, and she saw Bill struggling under a pack, but there was no sign of Roberts. Then more cedars intervened, and the campsite was lost to view.